A very warm good evening to one and all. Welcome to geography class. As you all can see, what we are going to study in today's video, water resources. As we all know that India is a land of rich natural resources, water being one of the most vital of all. So as the demand for water is increasing rapidly with the increase in population, where the supply of water remains the same. So let's see what we are going to cover up in this chapter. The introductory part. Our water resources are basically divided into three parts. First is surface water, second is the groundwater, third is the lagoons and backwater. Okay, so we are going to study them in detail. First is surface water. Surface water, rainfall is the main source of fresh water in India. So surface water is basically available on the surface of the earth in the form of river, lakes and ponds, sometimes in canals also. However, the river comprises the most important source of surface water, and India is blessed with large number of major, medium and small size of rivers. Next we have groundwater. So the part of rainwater that seeps through the cracks and crevices into the ground is called groundwater. Groundwater represents one of the most important water sources in India. So the distribution of groundwater is very uneven in India. For example, in some areas groundwater exists in deep aquifers, while in the others the water is thrown near the surface. So it is unevenly distributed. So here you can see the figure of groundwater. Next we have lagoons and backwater. So what are lagoons? A lake of salt water that is separated from the sea by sand or rock. So India has a very long coastline stretching over more than 6,000 kilometers, and they serve as a surface water resources. Although the quantity of water is generally brackish in nature, so basically these are used for fishing, irrigating, paddy crops and coconut. Next we have irrigation part. So India is basically an agriculture country where nearly 2/3 of its population depends on the agriculture production. Okay. So what is the exact definition of irrigation? The process of supplying water to crops by artificial measures such as canals, wells, tube wells, lakes, from the existing natural sources of water like rivers, tanks, ponds or underground water. So India is a land which experiences a tropical monsoon type of climate, which is unfortunately erratic, unreliable, irregular and unevenly distributed. So this variation of Indian climate make irrigation indispensable for sustained agriculture development. Okay, so there are following reasons justified to the need of the artificial application of water through irrigation to land. Number one is uneven and uncertain distribution of rainfall. Second, the rainfall of India is restricted from June to September except in Tamil Nadu, which receives rain in winters too. So next we have methods of irrigation. So they are basically divided into two broad categories, primitive methods of irrigation and modern methods of irrigation. First we are going to talk about the primitive methods of irrigation, which covers canal irrigation, tank irrigation and wells. So canal irrigation, which is further subdivided into indirection canal and perennial canal. Now what is canal irrigation? This is a type of irrigation which is more prevalent in northern part of the country where the rivers are perennial. Perennial means the river flows throughout the year. They don't dry up. Okay. So what are the conditions necessary for digging canals? The two main requirements for canal irrigation are low level relief, perennial source of water, and perennial source of water that is snow fed rivers, which may be used for the development of canal irrigation. So the water from this river is stored by building dam or weir across the river. So if we broadly speaking canals in India, they are of two types, indirection canals and perennial canals, which we are going to talk in a very detailed manner. First we have indirection canals. So these canals are taken out from the rivers when they are in flood and there is excess of water. So they are regulating systems like weirs and barrages at their head to regulate the flow of water. we talk about the advantages of this river canal, so they are easily and cheaply built. They are useful in controlling floods. If we are talking about the disadvantages, these are uncertainty of water supply. These are canals are useful only during flood period. Only low land areas can be irrigated. Next, we have perennial canals. What are perennial canals? These canals are useful throughout the year as they draw their water from perennial rivers, artificial lakes, or barrages or constructing across the rivers. If we talk about the advantages, these canals serve throughout the year. So the agriculture production in the area of less or uncertain rainfall has increased considerably. Second, these canals supply water even during hot season. Cultivation of some crops can be carried round throughout the year. If we talk about the disadvantages, there are problem of salt affinesses due to overflowing and flooding of the field, which makes the soil unsuitable for farming. Next, we have water logging in case of unlined canals as water soaks into the adjoining areas, turning them into swampy area. Okay, and it is an expensive method. So irrigation by canal is more suitable in northern India as compared to southern India due to the following reasons. So here you can see the irrigation canal in the video. So this is a perennial river. So the demand of irrigation is greater in the northern part as this is predominantly an agriculture region where proportion of an affordable land is highest due to high fertility of soil than the other areas of the country. So thank you students for listening to the lecture. I hope you enjoyed the lecture and do subscribe my channel. Thank you.